Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about Mollerian dark anomaly. Mollerian dark anomaly is an abnormal development in proper fusion or failure of resorption of Mollerian dark structure. Most of this case is symptomatic. Symptoms may develop at menarche, like primary amenorrhea, dysmenorrhea, cyclic abdominal pain. Epidemiology. Incident is estimated at 1%. Imaging. Abnormal contour of the uterus and or structural abnormal disease of endometrial cavity or vagina. Septate uterus is most common Mollerian dark anomaly, around 55%. MRI is best for definite diagnosis. Always image kidney to look for a renal anomaly. This is T2 MRI of a septate uterus so that the outer condyle contour is smooth and the intercorneal angle is less than 75%. This allows signal fibrous septum extending along the length of the endometrial cavity to a single cervix. Ultrasound shows the outer contour north of this bicornuate uterus due to a small amount of pre-fluid in the pelvis. The two endometrial cavities are separated by myometrium. T2 MRI, so two separate uterine horns, two cervix, and a massively distended vaginal valve in this patient with hydrometropathy and obstructed diaphysis. Ultrasound in another case of uterus diaphysis, so widely separated uterine horn. Transfer ultrasound shows a big conuate uterus with an external condyle cleft and two symmetric conules that are fused inferiorly. T2 image shows two different patients, each with big conuate uterus. The left image shows widely divergent uterine horn with a low signal septum extending to a single cervix, which was confirmed on vaginal scopy. The right image shows two symmetric conules that are fused caudally with a concave outer condyle contour. Treatment. Septate versus biconuate uterus is important. Septate treated with hysteroscopic resection of septum. Biconuate rarely requires surgery. Medical suppression of meningitis. Surgical removal of rudimentary horn, relief obstruction, resection of uterine septum. Thank you.